Generic greetings. Figured I'd start recording. Don't know if I'll do a full episode. I probably will, but just for the heck of it. But, just had something pretty darn weird happen. I've been fooling around here for quite some time. I've gotten a bunch of stuff done. But just now, I was trying to use the, E for entities thing up in the corner there, in the F3 menu. That E represents the number of entities currently rendered, I guess. Yeah, I died. I was trying to locate the cave, which is somewhere around here. Oh, that's where it is. Okay. That would explain some things. I got right about to here, and then I got annihilated by an Enderman. I don't understand what happened. It was pretty weird. He just came out of nowhere and started attacking me. As far as I can tell, I didn't really do anything to that might have pissed him off. I mean, I didn't look at him. Not really. I mean, there wasn't really any way I could look at him. I hadn't spotted the cave yet, so there's... I can't see how I could have accidentally looked at him. I knew he was around. I was hearing him. But, oh, this is a big cave. Oh, this is a very big cave. Well then, that explains why I was seeing so many entities. Oh! A slime! I'm very happy to see you. I'll kill you. Ha. Awesome. That is good to know. I will... Somehow I will mark this spot. That's approximately where I saw the slime. There we are. There's another slime ball there, huh? I don't have my sword readily available. This is bad. Hang on. So yeah, I've been doing a little bit of caving. Not much. This is the second cave I've really explored. That's an archer. Steer a little bit clear of that area. Nope, never mind. Okay, I'm fighting him. Fighting him! There's two of them. I wonder if there's a dungeon. Actually, that would make me happy. Shit, it's almost looking like there is, except... I don't know, a pack could spawn like this. I might die! I hope I don't... Nope, okay, we might be good. We might be good. Need to regen hearts, though. Alright, so yeah, I was using the E, if you see up here, look where my default skin is looking, I guess. Up towards the top there, there's an E. The numbers after the E are 20/112. The 100-something number, it's now 108. That's the total number of entities that... that the game is keeping track of, so basically in loaded chunks, I guess. That's the number of entities there are. And then the 16, 15, is the number which are within my field of vision. So where I'm looking right now, that's how many would be visible if my eyes could pass through rock and I could see forever. And entities can be dropped items, they can be... I just realized I wasn't regenning, so I'm gonna do that. They can be dropped items, they can be mobs. Those might be the only two. Those are the two primary ones anyway, the ones you'd usually have to worry about. There's more cave up here. I'm actually running out of wood. Been using a lot on tools and on torches, because I've needed a lot of torches lately. Did a lot of mining. I'll just record a full episode here. I may as well show you guys what I've been working on, where I'm at. I'll take care of this cave first, though. If we find a skeleton spawner, that would be excellent. Although I'm suspecting that that was just a pack of skeletons that spawned all the same time in the same area. That would make sense. Coal is nice. I'm actually enjoying mining coal, and I'm less likely to leave coal behind where I might have before, just because it does give you the XP now. It's nice. I was up at like level 20 something a little while ago, because I was just doing some mining, and I got a whole bunch of stuff, some redstone, a bunch of lapis, a bunch of iron. I'm okay for iron now, depending on what I want to do. I'm pretty well off. And some gold as well, not much, like one strip. And I didn't find any diamonds. But I was still up at like 20-something levels, and I hadn't fought practically any monsters. So it's crazy. For the record, I then went on to make a couple stupid mistakes, and I died in lava. I didn't actually die in lava. I died because of lava, because I was stupid, and I let it flow onto my position, then I escaped, and I was like, oh god, damn it, and I was on fire. I ran away, and I died anyway. I collected all my stuff, nothing was lost, but my levels. Those are ender particles. That makes me feel uncomfortable. It makes me feel quite uncomfortable. I don't know what to think about that. I have another pick. Good. Yeah. That startled me more than it should have. That startled me way more than it should have. I've got a huge dark cave right there. That's probably why. I don't know if you saw my screen spaz, but like a spasm, like legit ran through my body. That was pretty terrifying. I'm on edge right now because of that experience with the Enderman. I don't know, that was weird. If another Enderman just comes over and decides that I should be dead, then, you know, I will be dead. That's the way it is. And this one Enderman is still hanging around someplace. I mean, I didn't kill him. I saw him leering over my corpse when I was dead. That was basically all I saw of him. All of my stuff dropped to the ground when I died. So yeah, what I was doing originally there, I was taking a break from legit mining. As you probably saw, I started off like halfway from bedrock. I don't know where I am now. Actually, I do. I'm at 30. So, yeah, I'm at 30. Probably halfway or so. And I was just gonna try and identify. I was gonna try and find a cave based on the entities. Yeah, because a big cave will have a bunch of mobs in it, generally. And so I was gonna look for a big cave or, you know, mine shaft, whatever. And so I tried to find like the direction with the most entities in it. Oh, that looks interesting. There is. Oh, look at that. That's pretty. That's really pretty. I like that. Let's see. Probably got zombies down below. Oh, a creeper died there. Probably drowned, I don't know. Oh no, it fell off. Bet it fell off. This is a big ravine. I don't know. I don't encounter that many ravines, but I feel like this is a big one. I feel like they're not usually this big. And I think this connects to at least a couple other caves. That's what it looks like. Oh, floating gravel. Yeah, it's another thing. Let me tell you, there is so much gravel around on this map. I don't know if that's normal, but, like, I haven't done this in a while, and there is so much gravel. And it is so annoying. Down there. That's fine, too. So I don't know what the heck I'm gonna do with this. This is cool. probably end up building something. This is just so grand. See how far it extends in any direction and so on. It looks like it keeps going there. That's nice. It's quite nice. Hopefully it intersects with an abandoned mine shaft, because I want to find one of those things. That would be good. But after I collect just a little bit more coal, in the future I probably will cut out most of this coal mining. I need to remember to do it off camera, because it is probably pretty boring to watch. But yeah, let's see. I'll head back to my main base area. Need to clean this up. Wait, where's... Oh, I'm all the way... I tunneled down from up there, that's right. To make this more accessible, I don't know. Yeah. I inadvertently made, like, an entire set of, like... I made, like, a maze for myself here. I was tunneling off in all kinds of different directions trying to figure out where all the mobs were. I had, like, a cluster of, like, 13 or something. It was crazy. I imagine it was just, like, that cave with one or two caves behind it or something. But... Also, there is another thing which I was working on. This. Yeah. Yeah, it took a while to haul all that out. This area. This was basically just a blank wall before. And I did this. Basically, this is going to be the mob spawning area. Sort of. Not this itself, but underneath our feet. As you can sort of see, I outlined four circles in the floor, which will become cylinders. And those will be the mob spawning towers, if you will. Like, they'll probably extend 20 blocks down, if I've done the math right. And they should be pretty good. They're so big, and I'm gonna set up the water streams in a particular way. Each floor is going to be 5 blocks, and it's going to have 40 spawning spots. Yeah, it should be cool. And there will be these 4 cylinders 20 blocks high, and they will be filled up with... It's kind of difficult to, like, explain, but trust me, it'll be cool. There will be lots of different floors, and mobs will spawn on each floor. And water streams will push them down into the center of each one, and they'll probably be sent up a central water elevator through here. This will be like a stairway down, like a spiral staircase down, with the central water elevator here, and they'll just sort of float right up, and then from there we can decide what we're going to do with them. That is to say, I can decide what I'm going to do with them. I've already started again. But yes, one way or another, I will convert this entire area and well below into the mob spawning area. It's going to be gigantic, and hopefully it will be effective. And if Etho has taught me anything, it's that I do need to light up the caves around in order to make it most effective. What are you doing there? Is he a statue? I don't remember installing a shrubbery in my house. I do not remember installing this. I don't even have a sword. Well then, I don't remember installing that shrubbery. Minecraft, the game of self-installing, self-destructing shrubberies. I don't have the materials to make a sword quite quick and easy. I mean, I could, but I guess I will. Actually, you know what? I think he's gonna be our mascot. see if I can pull this off. You see me? Can you see me? Can't tell if he can see me. I was gonna try and trap him there, but maybe I can just trap him here. I don't think he can see me. Is he a ghost? I'm still really, really cautious here. I don't know what's going on here. This is weird. But I'm just waiting for me to just like get that one block closer and he's gonna just blow up. But he doesn't appear to be tracking me. He doesn't appear to be. He's not material. He's not even material. Okay. He was not here before. let me clarify that. I think I will put him in his little pen here, and he'll be there, and hopefully, it would be kind of cool if he just stayed there. I don't know what's gonna happen to him. This is weird. I've never had this happen before. I can't attack him. He's not actually there. He's an apparition. So I have a creeper apparition in my house. I need to give him a name now. Darn it. He's Carter, okay? That's Carter. He'll be my friend, or at least my ghostly apparition of a creature. Ghostly apparition of a creeper. And he will sit there, I guess. I wonder if I'm gonna find more of those. That's weird. I wonder if it's like different mobs. There was something I was reading on Reddit that some guy was experiencing sort of ghost mobs. Like, I think he called them his terracotta army. They were just sort of standing there, not doing much. That's freaky. That's weird. Anyway, you can see what I've done with this place. I've started off branch mining, going down each of these strips. I didn't mean to break the torch. But as you can see, I quite quickly hit a nice big lava lake, so I should be set for lava for a while anyway. Let me get this coal. I think it's just one block. Yep, it's just one block. Okay. There's also redstone over there, but I don't want to get that until I've actually dumped some water around here so it's safer. And preferably hollowed out just some of the lava around here. So I've headed out for quite a ways with at least some of these tunnels, and I'm probably going to continue with that. I think this top tunnel is, what am I at? I'm at 15 now. I think I would only be able to find diamonds in the floor. I looked it up, and as I recall, I'd only be able to find diamonds in the floor. But this level might have better chances, I'm not sure. That's just cobble and gravel, that's right. Okay. So yeah, I've started messing around with smooth bricks as well. Stone bricks. Which are pretty cool. I mean, Etho used them a lot, and I'm sort of using them for the same reason. They're a good thing to do with your excess cobble, and they look really nice, and they're easy to make. And now they have the added bonus of giving you XP when you make the smooth stone, which makes me happy. I want my ordinary avatar back. It's weird having Steve here. So yeah, I'm probably gonna build the stairway down here, more or less first. And then eventually I'll get to building this area. I'm gonna be incorporating redstone and stuff. I wanna add lamps, like on the certain areas. I've like figured out the redstone, in creative. It's just a matter of, actually implementing it and getting the materials to implement it in game. I'm gonna need to get glowstone, so I'm gonna need to find a village that happens to have some guy who's selling glowstone, because I think that you can get glowstone from certain villagers. Or I need to, find a way to get to the nether, and or I'm gonna need to find diamonds, get to the nether, and then, you know, go from there. Hi, Lorenzo. How are you doing? Good. Excellent. My cocoa beans are doing well. I've got 44 now. Nope, I've got 50. Just kidding. And I'm actually going to make some cookies because I did look it up and it's... I wanted to do the first batch on camera. Cookies! So now I'll probably have that as an alternate food source. I'll probably take a couple cookies and some bread with me so that I can... The bread for primary eating when I get down low to low health and whatever, and the cookies just to round it off to get to a nice even point without wasting any food so that I can... be regenning hearts, without actually, you know, get to that zone where I'm regenning hearts without actually wasting any food. That's what I'm trying to say. That's weird. That's so spooky. I don't understand. I don't understand at all. One of these times, watch, I'm gonna come over here, it's gonna blow up. It's gonna be horrible. But, at any rate, that's mostly what I've been up to. I'll take some of those with me. I'm happy that I found slimes. That's potentially really good, because I do want to use sticky pistons. And right now, I actually have everything that I'd need to do so. So, I do need some gunpowder, though. For one of my first projects that I want to do. It'll be cool. It'll be cool. Just you wait. It will be awesome. Oh, I wanted to experiment with floors and stuff here. Since I've already gone way over the 15-minute mark again, I may as well keep going. Let's see. Need wood. It's daylight, isn't it? Yeah, it's daylight. I think I'm gonna just go off and grab myself some... Yeah, okay. Grab myself some wood here. This time I'll actually replant some saplings. How's that sound? Oh, darn. See, I that's a pet peeve of mine. Like, I will always try to avoid using my axe to break leaves, because it seems so straightforward and simple, and, you know, like, why not? Yeah. It seems, like, so convenient and stuff, but at the same time, I don't know if people just don't know this or whatever, but that costs 2 uses of your axe. So it's like 2 logs that you could have just broken right there with your axe that you just wasted on some leaves. And you know, it's just so easy to switch to something else that won't get broken, you know. Same reason why I don't use my pick to whack at enemies, especially not like a diamond pick or something. I'm never gonna use that to attack people. Or, you know, creepers or zombies or whatever that are coming after me. If I don't have a sword, I will probably I don't know. It depends on how desperate the situation is, but I imagine I'll pretty much always just use my bare hands rather than waste my valuable pick. Just because that pick will get broken very quickly if I don't. I'm very frugal with my tools. Like, I preserve the resources so much. All the mining I've done so far, basically, so far, has been, I think I said so far twice. That was great. I think basically all I've done so far has been with stone picks. I've just been blowing through them. But because they're actually even renewable, and I have bunches of cobble anyway, I just, like, those, it's, yeah. I don't find I come across enough iron to justify upgrading to iron standard. If I get to that point where I've just got buckets and buckets of iron, I might, but at the same time, I am probably going to want to do some rail systems. I'm probably going to want to work with, I might get some armor, and I'm definitely going to be doing stuff with pistons, potentially lots and lots of pistons, so I want to leave that open as well. And I just find that if I waste all of my iron on picks, then it's pretty much counterproductive. I've got all kinds of animals wandering around. This is, it's good. It's very good. I've got cows, I've got chickens. I haven't seen any sheep. I don't think I've seen any sheep, which is a little bit unfortunate. But well, let's see. So, I do quite want to get to the end, and I will tell you why. I have plans. I have plans for when I get to the end. I may as well discuss them now, I suppose. It was going to be kind of a grand unveiling or some kind of garbage, but I may as well just talk about it now. So that I have something to talk about now while I'm doing boring stuff like harvesting leaves. Basically, what I'm planning on doing is converting the end and the fight with the Ender Dragon into sort of a Skyblock challenge sort of a thing. Yeah, it should be interesting. How am I going to do that? I am basically going to just take in what resources I can. Basically, an inventory is full, plus possibly an ender chest full. And I will head in there. I'll have a bunch of stacks of obsidian and some torches. And I will just head away from the end mainland by, you know, a couple hundred blocks or something. I forget exactly how far away I'll have to go, but I will probably look it up before I actually do it. Because if you get far enough away, the Ender Dragon, like, won't even be, it won't be keeping track of his position or whatever, something like that. And the boss health bar will actually even just disappear from your screen. So I want to just get far enough away and get him out of my hair and just do my own thing. And at the end of that cobblestone walkway, off where there is nothing but void, I will, not cobblestone, obsidian, so that he can't destroy it, where he might be able to. At the end of that obsidian walkway, there will just be, you know, nothing. And I will start going. I'll bring in a bunch of saplings. I'll bring in a bunch of, I'll bring in some, like some, a lava bucket, probably half a stack of ice or something. That kind of thing. And, you know, probably a bunch of diamonds too, in addition to the other stuff that one ordinarily brings to the Skyblock challenge. But I will just go for it, and I will go and go and go, and if I die, then basically, it's not like I lose the challenge, but I will sort of treat that as an excuse to go and get more materials. So, like, if I need more redstone, I will be bringing redstone. If I need more redstone, if I need more iron, if I need to bring that kind of stuff in, I'll just bring in a whole other load of stuff and continue building. It should be really cool. And eventually, the end goal will be, I'll probably bring in a crafting table and... Or rather, an enchanting table. Or at least the obsidian, the diamonds, and the reeds necessary to build one. And then I will bring in diamonds for diamond tools and armor. And the end goal of the whole pseudo skyblock thing will be to defeat the Ender Dragon, to actually head back over that cobble bridge and defeat the Ender Dragon. And that should be a big challenge. And if it gets too boring, or if I'm, you know, not getting anywhere, then I might kill myself deliberately in order to collect more materials from the overworld and go back to it, or just take a break. But we'll see. We'll see what happens and how it goes. And that's my plan for the end. And it should be a lot of fun, and I can't wait. So I'm probably gonna shoot for getting there as soon as possible, which will entail getting to the Nether and hitting a blaze farm, you know, that sort of thing. Probably gonna need to do something more than just traditional blaze hunting, because that can get dodgy at best. I was noticing over here that these seeds right here, they've not ever grown. So I'm suspecting that there's a rule that I don't know about, and I might have made a fool out of myself already. If everyone else knows about this, then I don't. But if there are other people out there that don't know about this, apparently, or at least so it would seem, seeds can't grow wheat can't grow if there's a block directly above. So that's my bet, and I'll just sort of assume that and go from there. So there we go. Let's see if they grow now. If they do, then I'm probably right. And we can assume that. So I'm probably going to end the episode here, because I've actually gone a little bit over 30 minutes. And it's been kind of boring and stupid anyway. So nevertheless, I'll probably get to uploading this. It looks like I've pretty much got that part of it down, which is good. Shouldn't be any issues. If there are, I will let you know about them in the description, I guess. if for some reason you care. So yeah. I guess I will come back with another episode at some point soon.